Hey children, today we are going to learn the lesson from your history part, tracing changes through a thousand years. The subtopic is region and empire. See my dear children, this image shows the Ghiyasuddin Balban, who was the Delhi Sultan during the period 1266 to 1287. How we know about him? That is from that information of poem. For example, on those period, the poem which has been written in Sanskrit language, which is denoted as Prashastis. The Prashastis means nothing but the poem which was written by the poeter regarding this king or sultan. See, my dear children, now I am going to show that a vast empire of Ghiyasuddin Balban in our country. See, this is the western part of India, which is called Gowda, that is Bengal. So here, it started from east to west to Ghazni, that is in Afghanistan, and which included all the portion of northern India. Then if you see, my dear children, started from east to west of the extension of this Ghiyasuddin Balban Empire, if we come to that southern India, here the Dravida also included because of his control of Ghiyasuddin Balban. So here the people of different regions, especially Gowda, Andhra, Kerala and Karnataka, Maharashtra, Gujarat, they fled before his armies. For example, not only from the Prashastis, if we can see the language and region which flourished during the period 1318, a poet whose name was called Amir Khusru, who belongs to Persian poet. Persia is the present Iran. So here Amir Khusru, who note down the languages of our country, for example Sindhi, Lahori, Kashmiri, which belongs to our country, the different states, how it is located, as like that, the languages also differ. So that Telangani in Andhra, and then Karnataka, Gujari in Gujarat. So like that Mabari in Tamil Nadu, and Gowri in Bengal. So like that, most of the languages which was denoted by Amir Khusru through his poem. Amir Khusru, who denoted about India and also common people. For example, he denoted about the Brahmanas who know about the Sanskrit, which was used to perform their yagnas and doing mantras and Vedas also. The thousand years of history that we are exploring witnessed major developments of religious traditions. For example, through prayers and singing songs, conducting bhajans, like that, the people, those who are having their divine power. As the social worlds of these groups altered, so too did their beliefs. It was during this period important changes occurred in what we call Hinduism today. These included the worship of new deities, the construction of temples by royalty, and the growing importance of Brahmanas, the priest, as dominant groups in society. Hope you all are understand this topic, my dear children. We will see in the next class. Thank you.